One of the first things I do for the binding is to establish the top of the binding, where I'm going to have it on the curve here. You can see right here I already have it established. But what I did, originally what I did was to take my calipers and measure the depth of the slot. Which is like 70 thousandths there. And then lock it in. And then with the end, I would, end of my calipers has the, I don't know if you can see it, it sticks out the bottom. But I would lay that on the side perpendicular like that, like a marking gauge. And I would hold it tight and go as it came down and hit the side. It would score that. And score line, go slow and all the way, and it would score line. This line is cut. First time I used this technique was on the armrest. And also I make the step that I want the top edge of my binding to show this, so when you look at it, it looks like the binding is continuous. And I want this side to be the same. The same depth and width. So I scored it like that, like I said there, made a marking gauge. But on this one, I did that first to see kind of where the line was at, and then I just decided to try a little bit of different approach, where I took my Dremel and I made a little. There's the base I made, so I could do the curve. Wasn't a problem on the outside of the armrest, but with the rib rest, I made that, and I have my Dremel gauge, or my tip, to the proper depth. That was simply, and then what I did was slowly and surely just went in and ran the Dremel and just held it and cut the little bit of the line on the top there. So as you can see, it'll cut to that depth, and as this tapers back, then it's eventually going to cut all the way down, but it'll etch that line. If the router's higher, then it can't reach, but it's got it, so it cuts that plane out. It's a little tedious, that's how I did that one, that channel. Then I measure my channel depth, and it's 5/16. So that's what my purfling and binding height is, 5/16. Then I mark some tape that width. And I cut the tape. With a sharp, new sharp blade. Then I take the tape and I follow the line from the binding here that line all the way. So that'll be the bottom of my binding. Well, now that we're here, what I also did earlier,
my perfing
is a 16th of an inch, so I bought some pinstriping tape from the auto parts store, 16th of an inch, and I laid it following the curve. So I put the pinstriping tape on and I followed right on the edge of where this was sanded flat on the top of the bevel, and I just followed that edge all the way around. And returned it to the slot. So from this point, what I'll do is with my real sharp new blade, is I'll go and I'll score all the way around both sides of the 1/8 inch tape, or 16th inch tape. I'll score that and I'll score it so I get a little bit deeper and deeper till I get about 50 thousandths deep on this. But I'll just take my time and score down there. First go light. And then as you go the second time, you go a little bit deeper and it'll ride down into the existing pre-cut groove. Then I'll do the same thing on the bottom. I'll put this into my my body vise, and I'll score all underneath there. And then once that's scored out, it's just a matter of routing out. That's where the difficult parts comes in, because I'll route this out with probably like either 32nd inch spiral down cut bit, or I have some 20 thousandths and 22 thousandths. That way it gives me, I can go right down the center and then I could work both edges. The better I score, the better, because when I get up to the edge, it'll peel off the cut just like an inlay channel. And then it's a matter of installing the binding.
It's definitely this is the tedious part of it. But you gotta go slow.
Now I'm removing the tape. See what I got.
Gotta have good light and gotta have magnification, unless your eyes are really good. Closer you can see, the better. And take it slow.